often Sarah would have spells if she lost time. She saw the future, she heard voices from inside. The kind of voices she would soon learn to deny. Because at home they got her smile.
Friends, giving younger every year.
filling the potholes in our silver street. They're waking the neighbors up at noon. Now your friends are loud break and you're out on your brown lawn. You're raking the dirt with a broom. Now the seasons change and the storefronts change. Everything else stays the same.
You recognize the Planet of the Apes thing, right? This is a song I wrote a few years ago to wiggle myself out of a bad publishing deal. And I was supposed to write 4.6 songs. And I was supposed to do this for several years at that point. I was suspended or something like that. And if I turn in my 4.6 songs to my publisher, you have a contract, you're going to write so many songs a year. I didn't write that many songs, so I got in trouble. And for about 3 years on, I didn't turn the songs in because I thought, well, if I write 4.6 songs, it's just crap, and I'm not going to feel good about myself writing crap and turning it in. So I'll just forget about the money part and just fuck it. So, kind of integrity notion I had at the moment. And then last year I needed money, so I just made up some shit. I turned it in. I wrote the songs just, you know, a couple days. I go down to the basement and think about, you know, like, what have I been doing today? What have I eaten? Or if I just make something up. I gave him a Broadway show tune in case they wanted to sell that. Maybe that'd be worth something. And I gave him a boy band song. And this one, this was the this is the second one. And my friend Andrew just came in and just helped me out. And I did this in Australia.
Thank you.
settle down and live happily forever. After, what do you think of that?
Jokes on me, because David Hasselhoff had a number one hit in Germany. This is a relatively new song. This year has been the year of relatively new songs. I've been spending a lot of time in the studio and writing songs. I've gotten to the point where all I've done is write songs, so I'm going to start writing more songs about writing songs. That's not what this song is about. This song is, I don't know what this song is about. Son, look at all the people at this restaurant. What do you think they weigh? Look out the window to the parking lot at their SUVs, taking all of the space. They give no fuck. They talk as loud as they want. Phone down at Walmart, talk about some shit that's been on my mind, talk about the state of this great nation of ours. People look to your left, yeah, look to your right. See, we need concert. I'm still amazed at how much shit I had in my pocket when I showed up. I've got a friend that makes a lot of fun of me for how much crap I have in my pocket when I play a gig. So I'm just gonna, Joe, can you take this stuff? I might need the money. No, just the money. I might need the money. Just in case I have to, if someone gets upset with the show or something, or if someone yells "Summer of '69," I have to get their money back. People get me mixed up with this other tone. I played funk bass in the top 40 band. I played polkas on a digital sampler keyboard with a drum machine. And I know, well, actually, I was going to say I know all that shit, but I actually knew 5 songs, and the waiters and waitresses wanted to kill me because I programmed this, like, had lederhosen and the hat and everything, and my skinny, hairy, 17-year-old legs hanging out, and, roll out the barrel, we'll have a barrel. I don't even know if I should tell this story. I'll tell it, but it's, I've got a couple things that I've said at gigs, and I've had to go back and check with a lawyer to make sure that I was past the statute of limitations on them, and I was. Like how I paid for my first semester of college. It's a Hardee's fast food chain scholarship fund, which I made up. It was just taking money out of the cash drawer. It's true. I took I paid like a $3,000 tuition there with that. It's really easy. All you have to do is just calculate how much extra waste could possibly happen if everyone was really inefficient that night, and then you just charge customers off of the computer. Don't let it go into the enter. Figure up tax in your head for the things that are perishable, kind of. Just in case you want to try it, but fries, like, they don't sit there and count French fries, right? So you figure, you know, they wasted, you know, approximately 7 bags of fries. Well, there's a good $10. And then roast beef is a good one to do, and milkshake. There's no way to count how many milkshakes you did, really. You can kind of guess, but if you had a real sloppy night, you might have spilled some milkshake, so there's another $10. And if you do that every night, you got like $30, $10 of roast beef, $10, that's $30 a night, 30 times, so 7, and then so 20, 200 bucks. You know, over a year, I'm going to have to pay for college, so anyway. But I was also working in this, sorry, I know you didn't like come out to the fucking college lecture circuit series. I just start to talk sometimes, and it's something I have to do in order to remain musical for the rest of the night. Yeah. So you can all get up and go get corn dogs or something if you want to. Yeah, so I was dressed up to play polkas, and my father works a pretty rough job on a pretty rough side of town, or he used to at the time, and he let me borrow his car. And so I had his car and the stuff that was in it, and I was dressed up in my lederhosen with, you know, it was all really official stuff, came straight from Germany. And I played my little gig, and then I got in the car, and I went by a pretty rough gas station and went to fill up with gas, and I got back in the car and started to drive, and there's this guy in my car. And he was like, yo, take me to Mount Airy. I was like, oh man, I can't do that. You're gonna have to get out of the car. And he goes, I'm getting out, take me to Mount Airy now. And he started freaking out on me. It's like in the car, and I was 17. I was like, oh, what the fuck am I gonna do? So I looked down, and my father had three, just, you know, part of the job, had three weapons. He had a can of mace, and he had a knife, and he had a little pistol. And so I immediately ruled out the pistol part and the can of mace because I didn't want it to get back in my eyes. So I reached for the knife, and I went, you're going to have to get out of my car. And he did, which is fucking weird. Like, I don't know why he just didn't slice me with the knife. Because I was, you know why he didn't? You don't fuck with a guy in lederhosen with a knife, that's why. Guys, riding down the street with his knife. I don't remember the chicken dance anymore. You guys got some dorky parents like me. That's the only way you know that. You know the whole, like, okay, I'll play a song now.
Stand here two more hours till I punch
I'm trolling food court for girls. Yeah, it's the best job in the world. They know they're safe with me. They love my little mustache. They love a man in uniform. A rent, rent, rent a cop. Rent, a rent a cop. Rent, rent, rent a cop. Rent, a rent a cop. Rent, rent, rent a cop. Rent, a rent a cop.
To mix that shit up, no. That's one of my relatively new songs, and I think it's probably gonna go on my album. It's a really massive production on the record. It's got horns and all this shit, and I sat down and trying to figure out how to play it on piano. I was like, I just couldn't make myself do that one. So this is another new song on the record. It's called Late.
Some dirty words on a dirty wall, eating takeout by myself. I played the shows, got back in the van and put the walkman on. And you were playing. In some other dive, a thousand miles away. in the rest, so I can be free what you want to see. I've got the gesture and sounds, got the timing down. It's uncanny, yeah, you think it was me. Do you think I should take to hang me up or make the fix still stuck? I do the best imitation of myself.
Stumped me, because I swear I must have done 75 versions now of Rock This Bitch, because when someone asked for it, I tried to do it, and last night someone wanted me to do it techno, and I had to give them $1. Is there another style I can try? Actually, I haven't tried a polka. This bitch.
fucking way. You took the mother of all things, and even got the speech and moved the stone. My sweet mother, you can't see the vines from trees. You've never been out in the woods alone, so you can laugh all you want to.
Here's another relatively new piece of music. I'll try it out on you and see if pray for me.
There's a moment in my mind I scribbled and erased a thousand times, like a letter never written or sent. These conversations with the dead I used to be, a sentimental guy. Now I'm haunted by the left unsaid. I never thought so much could change. to learn to live with what you are. Thank you. next door, there's an old man who lived to his 90s and one day passed away in his sleep. And his wife, she stayed for a couple of days and passed away. I'm sorry, I know that's a strange way to tell you that I know we belong. That I
This song is about the same period of my life, man, that I got all that Hardy scholarship money. I started running out of funds for school, so I considered joining the armed forces. And I came pretty close, but every once in a while I really explain the song. Like, basically, I just seem to just kind of tell the whole song without the rhyme. And then
the song's about the Badlands, and it's called the Badlands.
So the song is about the army. It's called. It's in the key of A flat for those of you who have trumpets and saxophones on your person. If you didn't get the memo and you didn't bring the horns, then you can just sing it. And anyone who brought an acoustic guitar can come up on stage and we can do Horse with No Name. Doesn't look like that happened. So anyway, okay, so there's two parts. And this side can be the trumpets, and this side can be the saxophone. That includes the balcony. You can sing these two. This side does the part that goes ba 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 ba. Check it out.
I've been thinking a lot today. I say to my reflection, my peers and criticize me, and my ex-wives all despise me, try to put it all behind me, but my redneck past is nothing am I. I've been thinking a lot today.
See if I can do it higher. They had to carry me out last night after the song. This is in the key of G minor. The third saddest of all keys. One of my goals in my career is to be, at some point, to pull off successful heavy metal at the piano. It's the thing that keeps me up at night. Because I know I've got to be the ultimate sacrifice. Fish is gonna flop around in the video. Here I sit, broken hearted, came to shit, but only slowly walking down the hall. That's the name I can't hold. Where are you? Are we getting high? I bet you some fucking country band does cover that song in the next couple years. Something that's a trend I've noticed that in popular music in America, some fairly innovative black people will do something really cool. In about 5 years' time, the cool white people catch on. They water it down just a little bit. And then in about 10 years, the country people pick up on it. And right as it's going out of style for them, it comes back into style for somebody else. And then you get this really confusing moment where you have the coolest people have mullets for about 5 minutes. I couldn't fucking work it out. Like, should I grow the mullet or should I? And I actually did last year. I grew a mullet and a mustache just because I had said I'd done it in the song. And I didn't want to lie, so I had the mustache and the mullet for about a month, actually. And I didn't play shows during that time, but I was seen about in the mustache and the mullet. And something I realized about that particular style with the mullet And I'm tired of hearing about fucking mullets, really, but the thing about it is that you can't just, you don't just grow a mullet, you earn a mullet. And I didn't own it, so it didn't make any sense. I'm just going to play something for you. Oh, yeah. Okay, so here's a song about the kind of music that's likely to be taken over by country musicians in the next, I'd say, 5 years. And they're going to be playing that kind of pissed off white boy music.
Let me tell y'all what it's like being male, middle class, and white. It's a bitch if you don't believe. Listen up to my new CD, Shallow. I got shit running through my brain. There's so much that I can't explain. All alone in my white boy pain. I shake your booty while the band complains, yeah.
Thank you.
thanks a whole lot for coming out to watch my film, my silly songs. Means a lot to me. I really appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That's how you practice. You take it slow, none at a time. Don't try to run before you crawl.
Y'all like y'all a party?
On acid. I think the vocals sound really nice in this place. There's like no kind of basketball scoreboard up there or anything, so I'm ready to do it. People with the lowest voices give themselves this part. Slightly higher voices, take the minor third above that. Both parts together. Nice. Now people with the highest voices add the third, part, because... Actually, it goes more like this. All three parts together. Fixed.